Hey, welcome to new tutorial. Today we are going to learn another seed type, monocotyledons. We already made two tutorials on this chapter. You may check the links given up there. If you are new to this channel, please subscribe. Hit the bell icon just beside. Happy learning! Most of the common monocotyledonous seeds are albuminous. The large endosperm, the cereals, is the most important source of starch, the principal food of the people. Rice, paddy, maize may be taken as the type seeds of this class. They are the most important cereal crops of the world. In all this, the grains are actually fruits of the caryopsis type. The rice grain is tightly covered by the husks. In wheat, the husks are loose, while in maize, the husks are short and loose so that the grains are exposed. In all the three, the outer coating of the grain is formed by the fusion of the pericarp and the seed coat. The micropyle and the hilum cannot be found because of the pericarp covering. Inside, a large endosperm forms the bulk of the grain, while a small embryo occupies a comparatively small space on one side of the base. The outermost layer of the endosperm is the aleurone layer, which contains mainly protein. Of these three, maize has the largest embryo and the easiest to examine and dissect. Maize grains are flattened and more or less oblong. On the flat face, the embryo can be seen even from the outside as a whitish deltoid area. The wall is yellowish or red and so firmly adherent that it cannot be separated from the kernel. If the seed be cut longitudinally into two and the cut face stained with iodine, the endosperm part would take deep blue color because of starch and the embryo part would be yellowish. That can be easily demarcated. Usually, the upper and the outer part of the endosperm is horny because presence of more protein, while the inner part and the part nearest to the embryo is mealy white, as it contains mainly starch. On the upper side of the embryo is a shield sepit structure called the scutellum, which completely covers the endosperm. The tissue of the scutellum abutting on the endosperm forms the epithelium, which is a glandular tissue secreting enzymes to digest the food in the endosperm. The scutellum is actually the single cotyledon of monocots, whose leaf nature is not at all clear. Its only apparent function is the absorption of food materials from the endosperm. Lateral to this scutellum is a short axis and the lower part of which is the radicle covered by a sheath called the coleorhiza, and the upper part of it is the plumule showing a number of young lips sheathed by the coleoptile. A good preparation will show vesicular strands emanating from the middle of the axis, that is the first or the cotyledonary node, and ramifying in the scutellum. This is the path through which food travels to the axis. The region between the cotyledonary node and the base of the coleoptile, that is the first internode, is called the mesocotyl. The wheat grain essentially resembles maize. The grain is oval and there is a longitudinal groove along the ventral side. The wall is light brown. The endosperm contains a decreasing proportion of gluten, that is a protein, as it approaches the scutellum, giving it a more and a more mealy white appearance. The embryo resembles maize, but from the middle part of the axis, opposite the scutellum, a tongue-like outgrowth called the epiblast is seen. The epiblast is also in many other graminae. The rice grain shows a brown or red-brown wall. A lot of protein is contained in the aleurone layer, which along with the pericarp and seed coat gets rubbed off in course of polishing rice. The embryo also gets broken. This improvisation of polished grain in its vitamin, protein and oil contains. The epiplast is found here as well. One peculiarity of the rice embryo is that the plumule and the radicle do not lie on one straight line but form an angle between them. In wheat and rice, the embryo part is very small, only about 60% of the seed or less. There is some controversy around the morphology of scutellum, coleoptile, coleorhiza, mesocotyl and epiblast. The scutellum is usually regarded as the cotyledon, but some botanists prefer to include the coleoptile and mesocotyl within the cotyledon. The coleorhiza also is regarded by some as a downward prolongation of the cotyledon. Others regard the monocotyl as the first internode of the epicotyl and the coleoptile as a leaf. The epiblast is often regarded as a second suppressed cotyledon. There are a few seeds of this type which are rather peculiar. In coconut, the hard shell is the innermost layer of the fruit wall. There are three eye-like scars on the shell, below one of which the embryo lies. On breaking open the shell, the seed is found covered by a dark brown seed coat which is adherent to the kernel. The white kernel, including the milk within it, is the endosperm. The embryo lies embedded on the top of the kernel below one scar. In date palm or the palmyra palm and the betel nut, seeds are arranged in similar, but the endosperm is more or less solid and horny, containing reserved cellulose. The stony seed of date is covered by a brown tester. The hard endosperm has a longitudinal groove on one side, and on the center of the other side, the embryo is placed in a small pit. The embryo is similarly placed in betel nut and palmyra palm. In betel nut, the endosperm is ruminated as in anonasy. The small black seed of onion is covered by a seed coat. The inside is filled with a tough semi-transparent endosperm within which a curved embryo is embedded. The embryo shows a radicle on one end and a scutellum on the other. The plumule is not seen as the stage. It develops later. Although all the common monocotyledonous seeds are albuminous, there are few of the exalbuminous type. This type of seeds is found in the family of Aeroidae and the Hydrocharitaceae, Alismaceae, Naiadaceae, etc. The seed of Alisma shows a curved embryo with a radicle and a cotyledon. So these are all the examples we have studied for the monocotyledonous seeds. So this is it for today. We will come back with a new chapter in our upcoming video. So I have studied this chapter from the book, The College Botany. And this book is a very valuable to read, mainly the plant morphology. If you find anything fruitful from this video, please don't forget to subscribe our channel. If you have any queries or suggestion regarding this video, you can comment in the box below. Stay with us. Thank you.